Super Mario Land was Mario's first platforming game to hit the wildly successful Game Boy. And it was so successful, it got a direct sequel released on the same console in Super Mario Land 2, The Six Golden Coins. And if it wasn't for Pokemon or Tetris, would have been the best-selling games on the console. Despite its criticism for length, the game was ripe with lore. With that in mind, I'm your host, 24Kevin, here for 24KevinTendo, and this is the story you might not know about Super Mario Land 1 and 2. Super Mario Land is the shortest mainline Mario game in history, but that doesn't mean it doesn't have a good story to go along with it. As is tradition, let's go over the manual to start. Once upon a time, there was a peaceful world called Sarasaland. In this world, there were four kingdoms named Burabuto, Muda, Easton, and Chai. One day, the skies of Sarasaland were suddenly covered by a huge black cloud. From a crack in this cloud, the unknown space monster Tatonga emerged to try and conquer Sarasaland. Tatonga hypnotized the people of all the kingdoms so that he could control them in any way he liked. In this way, he took over Sarasaland. Now he wants to marry Princess Daisy of Sarasaland and make her his queen. Mario came to know of these events and has started on a journey to the Chai Kingdom, where Princess Daisy is held captive, in order to restore peace to Sarasaland. Can Mario defeat Tatonga, release the people from his interstellar hypnosis, and rescue Princess Daisy? It's all up to you and Mario's skill. Go for it, Mario! So it seems that Sarasaland's residents are a little more content with their leader, as the main bad guy Tatonga has been hypnotizing the inhabitants in order to get them under his control. Now for some of you who don't know, Mario did wind up saving Daisy, and then fans continued to theorize that Mario wound up with her because a heart appeared after her rescue. I personally do not agree with this, as a heart could be viewed as a grateful gesture, because if someone saved you from imprisonment, you would damn sure say I love you. With all credit to theorists out there, I take this as a heart of gratitude as opposed to a heart of love. One thing that led me to this conclusion is Daisy's trophy description in Super Smash Bros. Melee that actually reads, after her appearance in Mario Golf, some gossips started portraying her as Luigi's answer to Mario's Peach. Now, two things that we can infer from this is that Mario and Peach are in fact still a couple and the hot item of the Mushroom Kingdom. The other piece of evidence suggests that it's just gossip, but that Daisy and Luigi are in fact a couple as well. Gossip rumors, take it for what you will, maybe they're not a couple at all. But one thing we can discern for sure is that Mario and Peach are in fact a couple. Now, after his adventure in Sarasaland, Mario returns to Mario Land, seemingly without Daisy, presumably leaving her to rule over Sarasaland, as he encounters a familiar face. In the manual for Super Mario Land 2, the story is pretty well spelled out for us as well. While I was away crusading against the mystery alien Tatonga in Sarasaland, an evil creep took over my castle and put the people of Mario Land under his control with a magic spell. This intruder goes by the name of Wario. He has been jealous of my popularity ever since we were boys, and has tried to steal my castle many times. It seems he has succeeded this time. Wario has scattered the 6 golden coins from my castle all over Mario Land. These golden coins are guarded by those under Wario's spell. Without these coins, we can't get into the castle to deal with Wario. We must collect the 6 coins, attack Wario in the castle, and save everybody! Now, one interesting note about this game is that the only boss to make a return from the original Mario Land is Tatonga, and once again caused many fans to theorize that this was part of Wario's plan all along to take over the castle, and sending Tatonga simply as a distraction. But unfortunately, that isn't the case. In the Mario Encyclopedia, it actually stated that Tatonga teamed up with Wario in order to get revenge for stopping his and Daisy's wedding. Sometimes the simplest stories are the best. Now, one final thing of note that I noticed in the manual is that it stated Wario succeeded this time at taking over Mario's castle, seemingly thanks to the magic spell he cast in order to hypnotize the inhabitants of Mario Land. But where have I heard that before? I theorized that since Tatonga was out for revenge on Mario, He somehow lent Wario the same power he used to hypnotize the people of Sarasaland, presumably as he didn't want to face Mario head-on himself. Instead, he used Wario as a pawn to take over the castle and irritate Mario, going as far to hide a coin in his spaceland to deter Mario further. Eventually, Mario reclaims his castle and ousts Wario from Mario Land, coming home and saving the land once again. Although these games are quite short in comparison to other Mario games, they certainly made sure Mario was well taken care of in the portable market, opening up the road for future series installments. And that's all the time we got for today's episode. Leave a comment down below and let me know if there's any questions you guys have about Mario Land 1 or 2. We're coming up to Christmas soon, so I hope you guys have yourself a great holidays. For everyone here at 24KevinTendo, I'm your host, 24Kevin. See you guys next time. Hope you had a great day. Bye!